Hello there, duelists! In this tutorial, I will show you the basics of VFXing a duel.
Okay, let's get started. First, I will show you how to do the summoning effect. Okay, let's import our footage to After Effects and make a new composition with it. Just drag and hold it to the create a new composition layer. This is around here. And let's fetch it to cut the edges that what we don't need from the footage. Okay, let's review it.
Wait.
Matt.
Uh-huh. Okay, this is, will be the point where the scanner, the shot begins, yes?
Megidézem Junk Synchron. És a képességével visszahozom Headbutton.
And this is where it ends. Okay, let's rename the comp position. This is not important, this is just for me. And in this layer, let's right click and trim comp to work area. So it will cut the parts we don't need. Okay, let's go back. I will copy my color correction layer. This is not really important for this video, this is just for me, okay. And let's watch it again and add some markers. Okay, this is the part where he sounds Junk Synchron. I hit the star button on my keyboard and let's type Junk Synchron with a double kick into the layer marker. Okay, let's go forward. And here is Headbutt. So now I will know where to go when I want to use my effects. Okay. So let's do Junk Synchron. First I will import my Junk Synchron footage to After Effects and I will add it to the layer. So previously I marked myself that Junk Synchron will stand here. I hit S to scale up Junk Synchron. He will stand here, for example. And let's start the summoning effect because this doesn't look good at all. Okay, first we search in the effects and presets panel for CC scatter. Scatterize. With this effect, we can do this scattering effect, but first let's delete it and let's do something else. So mark Junk Synchron layer, precompose, move alt attributes into the new composition and hit OK. This is important because if we don't do this, you will see that Junk Synchron will only the effect will be only seen in this in like this, and this is not what we want. We want it to be seen in the whole image. Okay, let's go back. Layer, precompose, Junk Synchron, and double click to the layer, and composition settings, and extend the borders of this layer. So you will see why. Okay, we are back, and now you can see that if I applicate this scatterize effect, it will spread around the whole image, not just in the area. Okay, here, and now that we have scatterize effect, we can start the composition. Okay, first hit to the watch once, so we set keyframes and let's drag it. So let's say 71 and go like 22 frames away, for example here, and set it to 0, so it will come like this. applicate motion blur both here and both in the composition, so it will look more realistic to the eye. And next we create the CC radial blur. Type fading zoom, and let's open this panel and let's go like here. Let's hit 12. Center is in the center, and let's click on the watch here on the amount so we can set keyframes. Let's go a bit further, set 0. Let's watch it again. Okay, it looks good. And now we will need curves to make some color adjustments. Okay, go a bit before the ending of the scatter effect and hit the watch here in the curves up to here. Yes, this is it. This is what we want. This is the color what we want. Okay, now go after the scatterize effect finishes and hit this line here, both for this and as well as for the blue. So it will look like the holographic animation. Yes. And now that we finish this, let's go and wave a warp. Yes, this will give us the holographic effect, but not like this. We have to set the wave type to scare, the direction to 0, and wave height to 1, and wave width to 10. So it will look like a holographic image. You can see this fine waving. Now we need one more effect, and it's noise. We don't need to add much noise. For example, 2% is enough. It will add some noise, so it will look like more like a hologram. Okay, and now let's duplicate this layer, Control plus D, and we have to delete the wave warp and the noise, disable these effects for a moment, and go layer auto trace the current frame and hit OK, and it will mask your object around. Okay, now we will applicate the Saber plugin. This is a free plugin, you can download it from Video Copilot. It's completely free and it's a wonderful plugin. It is really a dream. Okay, so let's applicate this Saber plugin and move it to there. And let's drag it and move it to above the other effects, and select a preset to burning. But first we have to change, okay, it's saving, we have to change the render settings and the customization core. One moment. Change it to mask core and customize core and layer masks. So it is around our image, it is around our mask, so it follows the mask we created with auto trace. Let's change the blending mode, which is here, toggle switches per modes, and change it to add. and reapply these effects: CC cutters, CC radiolver, and curves. Here we have it. This is how I do the summoning effects. This is the effect. I usually add some extra, for example, make these two layers 3D composition and turn the monster to fit more to the scene. I usually add some HUD, HUD, you will see what I'm thinking, HUD element before the monster is summoned, for example. It's okay, change it, add some tint, change it to blue, and it will look more like a hologram. Additional effect you can do is add some shadows, for example, here, layer, new, solid, color, black, name it shadow, change the blending mode to overlay, and go to pen tool, or hit G, draw a mask around your monster, click on the visibility, maybe it's not that good, change back the blending mode to normal, hit F, change the feather, and like this, and the monster will have a shadow under here, so it will look like more than it is on the screen. Okay, so that was it. In my previous video I already showed how I created the life point or attack point counter, so this is it. And the good thing in it that once you create this effect I just showed you, you can apply it on everything. For example, let's search for Great Ogre, Sound Great Fox, I know. So you just basically layer, pre-compose, move, and you move it to here. You click on the auto trace. I'm current flame, not Furkara. You will have the mask around it. Duplicate the layer. Control. Copy and paste the effects from Junk Synchron. You hit A and you copy all these effects. Control C. Change the blending mode to add. Let's move it elsewhere. Let's copy the other effect. Add it to here. And here you are. You don't have to start it from the beginning. You just copy it once you have done it. And that's all for the basics. Okay, thank you for watching. If you like this video, maybe I will show more, for example, setting card, activating card, and so forth. Okay, goodbye, duelists.